Brenton Owa just caught up with Congresswoman Colleen Hanabusa. She's been handing out supplies on the Big Island.
And he joins us live from Pahoa with more. Brenton.
Hey, Yunji, Paula, we're out here in Pahoa. And while the background over here might look nice, this is not a representation of what it looks like out in this community. A lot of residents still trying to recover. There's a lot of damage out here, and you know, no matter how much we show you the pictures, the video, the broken houses, no power, no water, it's kind of hard to understand what they're going through out here until you actually put a foot on the ground. And joining us is a person, Congresswoman Colleen Hanabusa, who put your foot on the ground. You tried to postpone this election. Mm-hmm. Today it didn't really rule in your favor. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think that it's unfortunate for the people of Puna, because as you know, the sense, even with the judge, when he ruled the way he did, he said that it lacked common sense that they're proceeding. He knows that the people do not want this election to proceed. And in addition to that, he said it was insensitive to what's going on in this community. However, he could not overrule the Office of Elections because he felt that they had the discretion to do what they're doing. The feedback from the people who were there is that, you know, they don't understand why government's basically doing this to them, why they can't have the time to recover. And I think that when you really think about it, you know, we always talk about people participating. And why is it that we are insensitive to the fact that they are going through a very critical time in their lives? Notwithstanding that, the election is going to go forward because someone in Honolulu made a decision as to what's best for the people of Puna, that the people of Puna do not agree with.
Not only did the judge say it was insensitive, he also said it lacks common sense. People we talked to, a lot of them said the same kind of thing. They're just trying to survive day by day. Have you heard, have they talked to you about this tomorrow, whether they'll show up or not?
You know, as you know, we're at Maku'u Marketplace, so the people is the whole Puna district. So, you know, we're not asking people by where they live, because it is going to differentiate by where they live as to whether they're going to participate tomorrow. A lot of people are saying that they want to vote, but they may not necessarily be in the right precincts to vote, which is also an unfortunate situation because they again made a decision by which polling place was open versus whether people could get to the polling places.
What do you guys do now? You guys are out here passing out food to them. You'll be here again tomorrow. Mm-hmm. What for you guys for this election, for this special election?
Well, you know, what we do want people to know is that there is an election tomorrow, and that for people in Hawaii Paradise Park, which is right across the highway from us, that they've got to go all the way to Hawaii Beaches, which is about 8.1 miles away, in order to vote. Unfortunately, as you can see, there's not enough signage. There's not enough information out there to tell people that this is going on. And we have been trying to do our best to get the information out to people and also to tell them they need rides, because a lot of people still do not have access in and out of their driveways, that we'll be happy to assist. But, you know, this is one of those situations. This is where we're at, and we are going to do everything we can to help people get out and vote tomorrow.
Now, I don't want to be a naysayer, but last question, going back to court today. Attorney for the state said, you know, depending on the results, you could challenge it in the Supreme Court. I don't want to say that you're going to lose, but if you don't get the votes in your favor, is that something that you're looking to do?
Well, you know, it's really more a matter of what the court said, how it said it, what it found, and what's in the record. So that's something that the legal team is looking at and evaluating, irrespective of what the outcome is. So we'll look at it.
All right. Thank you, Colleen. Guys, we're going to send it back to you right after this. Augie T will be performing back there, trying to bring some smiles to this area. Colleen Hanabusa and her campaign will still be out here as well, and tomorrow too. We'll bring you that later on at 10. Live in the Big Island, I'm Brenton Owa for KITV 4 News.
Brenton, thank you so much for that live report. And in response to the ruling today, the campaign manager for Senator Schatz released the following statement saying, quote, Senator Schatz continue to focus his energies on helping the people of Puna recover, and that's what he will do on an ongoing basis. His commitment to recovery in Puna extends beyond the election.